Namaskar. Welcome to the lecture on food spoilage by microorganisms. Microorganisms are microscopic, living, single-celled organisms such as bacteria. Ubiquitous throughout the world, microorganisms play a vital role in supporting and maintaining nature and life. Although some bacteria are harmful and some are beneficial bacteria, example lactic acid bacteria, etc. This episode deals with different types of spoilage microorganisms with special reference to food, for example, meat, milk, vegetables, canned products, etc. The following topics are highlighted: food spoilage, different types of spoilage bacteria, wide variety of fungi spoil foods, spoilage of meat and dairy, and the common foodborne pathogens. Coming to the first part, which is food spoilage. Spoilage caused by microorganisms like fungi, that is molds and yeast and bacteria. They spoil food by growing in it and producing substances that change the color, texture and odor of the food. Eventually, the food will be unfit for human consumption. Food spoilage directly affects the color, taste, odor and consistency or texture of food, and it may become dangerous to eat. The presence of a bad odor or smell coming from food is an indication that it may be unsafe. Spoilage bacteria can cause fruits and vegetables to get mushy or slimy, or meat to develop a bad odor. Spoilage bacteria. Spoilage bacteria are microorganisms too small to be seen without a microscope that cause food to deteriorate and develop unpleasant odors, tastes, and textures. Microorganisms can cause fruits and vegetables to get mushy or slimy, or meat to develop a bad odor. Different types of spoilage bacteria. Mesophiles prefer moderate temperature ranging from 41 degrees Fahrenheit, that is 5 degrees Celsius, to 50 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 10 degrees Celsius. In a favorable medium, these bacteria double their numbers in as little as 30 minutes. Psychrotrophs can grow at about 32 degrees Fahrenheit, that is at 0 degrees Celsius, the freezing temperature of water, but grow best at moderate temperatures. Thermophiles prefer a warmer temperature. The optimum temperature for growth is usually between 131 degrees Fahrenheit, that is 55 degrees Celsius, and 149 degrees Fahrenheit, that is 65 degrees Celsius. Some can grow in temperatures as low as 95 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 35 degrees Celsius, or as high as 167 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 75 degrees Celsius, to 194 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 90 degrees Celsius. These grow at temperatures above 45 degrees Celsius. Often their optimum growth temperatures is between 50 degrees Celsius and 70 degrees Celsius. Growth of some bacteria occur at 80 degrees Celsius. Bacteria in this group are mainly spore formers and are of importance in the food industry, especially in processed foods. Anaerobic or facultatively anaerobic spore formers are most likely to grow in canned foods. Microaerophilic bacteria are most likely to grow in vacuum-packed foods since they have low oxygen tension. Aerobic bacteria are likely to grow on the surface of raw meat. Aerobic molds will grow in insufficiently dried or salted products. Psychrophiles. These prefer low temperatures. They can grow at temperatures of 32 degrees Fahrenheit, that is 0 degrees Celsius or lower. But they can also thrive at moderate temperatures of 59 degrees Fahrenheit, that is 15 degrees Celsius, to 68 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 20 degrees Celsius. They are quite common in environments where the temperature remains consistently low. They are mainly of marine origin. Yeast. Yeast can be responsible for the decomposition of food with a high sugar content. The same effect is useful in the production of various types of food and beverages such as bread, yogurt, cider, and alcoholic beverages. Effect of spoilage on various food products. Protein food. They go putrefied when they are contaminated. This is the situation where protein foods rot and produce very bad smell. Carbohydrates. Cooked cereals become marshy and slimy when affected by microorganisms. This condition is known as serinasis. Flour products smell and taste unpleasant when they are spoiled. They're described as being stale. Fruits and vegetables, they rot, ferment and decay. Microorganisms that spoil and contaminate poultry. Microorganisms that contaminate poultry immediately after obtaining surface of carcasses is mainly contaminated with bacteria of the genera Acinetobacter, Flavobacterium, but superficial rotting is produced primarily by Pseudomonas, that is the fluorescens, putide, fraggy, etc. and to a lesser extent by Aeromonas, Acinetobacter and Moraxella. Generally, bacteria exist in higher numbers at the time of processing on the skin of chickens and in their intestinal tracts are primarily mesophiles. These bacteria do not multiply to an appreciable degree at refrigerator temperatures. Salmonella, Escherichia coli and other bacteria found on chickens are mesophiles. Unlike marine animals, on the freshwater fish are found or often found bacteria family, Enterobacteriaceae and the genus Aeromonas. Mollusk's meat is contaminated with a large number of microorganisms, that is 104 to 106 per gram, especially gram-negative bacteria such as Vibrio, Pseudomonas, Acinetobacter, Moraxella and Flavobacterium. Wide variety of fungi spoil foods. Some of the most common fungi include Rhizopus, Alternaria, Penicillium, Aspergillus, Botrytis. Fungi grow readily in acidic, low moisture environments. Meat are more perishable than other food commodities. It contains all the nutrients required for growth of bacteria, yeast and molds. Whiskers, mucor rhizopus, black or green spots caused by Cladosporium penicillium. Ground meats and steaks are almost exclusively spoiled by bacteria. Storage temperature selects for psychrotropic spoilage organisms. Pseudomonas, Moraxella, Acinetobacter, Psychrobacter, etc. Steaks tend to undergo surface spoilage. Canned goods spoilage. Canning is a method of preserving food in which the food contents are processed and sealed in an airtight container. Canning is a way of processing food to extend its shelf life. Canned foods, thermophilic spore formers, can cause some types of spoilage of low acid, that is high pH foods such as corn, beans, peas. When the cans are temperature abused at 43 degrees Celsius and above, even for short duration. Spoilage due to insufficient heating, Clostridium and some bacillus species. Spoilage due to container leakage. Spoilage in canned foods caused by leakage can be caused by a variety of microorganisms that do not normally survive the heat treatment. These microorganisms usually enter at the start of cooling through a faulty seam and produce a swelled can. Canned foods are classified as low acid, acid, or high acid products, and each group has characteristic spoilage microorganisms whose growth is most often due to inadequate processing. Low acid canned foods, most products, pH is greater than 4.6, for example, milk, meat, many vegetables, etc. Because of the concern over Clostridium botulinum growth, these foods must receive the highest heat treatment. Flat sour spoilage by thermophilic spore formers such as Bacillus stearothermophilus, which is a strict aerobe, and Bacillus coagulans, which is a facultative anaerobe. Can does not bulge flat, but pH falls and food tastes sour, off odors may be apparent. Sulfide spoilage by anaerobic thermophilic spore formers that produce hydrogen sulfide like Clostridium nigrificans and Clostridium bifermentans. The gas is often absorbed by the food, so can may not swell, but the odor is unmistakable. Blackening of the food may also be observed. Gaseous spoilage by putrefactive anaerobes like Clostridium butyricum. The can swells and the food may have a fermented, cheesy or putrid odor. High acid foods with a pH lesser than 4, for example fruits, a few vegetables and fermented products like sauerkraut. Spoilage is usually due to non-spore forming mesophiles like yeasts, mold and lactic acid bacteria. Specific food groups. Bacterial genera commonly infecting meat while it is being processed, cut, packaged, transported, sold and handled include Salmonella species, Shigella species, Escherichia coli and Staphylococcus aureus, Bacillus cereus and Fecal streptococci. These bacteria are all commonly carried by humans. Infectious bacteria from the soil include Clostridium botulinum. Among the mouths commonly infecting meat are Penicillium, Mucor, Cladosporium, Alternaria, etc. Whole meats. Fresh meats are among the most perishable foods. The microflora of fresh meat is composed primarily of gram-negative aerobic rods such as Pseudomonas, Acinetobacter and Moraxella, Bacillus and Clostridia, for example, Clostridium perfringens, are also common on all types of meat. Storage temperature is the single most important control factor for meat spoilage. Sources of contamination. Several genera of molds grow on the surface of meat and can cause spoilage, but cannot grow on meat stored below 5 degrees Celsius. Usually, fresh cut meats in the refrigerator at high humidity undergo bacterial spoilage by gram-negative aerobes like Pseudomonas, Acinetobacter and Moraxella species. Meat spoilage is characterized by the appearance of off odors and slime, which are manifest when surface loads exceed 107 colony forming units per centimeter square. Vacuum packaged meats. 80% of beef leaves packing plant in vacuum package. Not all oxygen is removed during packaging, but residual is consumed by respiration of aerobic microorganisms and the tissue itself. Results in increased carbon dioxide levels and thus get a longer shelf life. If nitrites have been added to the vacuum packaged meat, for example to inhibit Clostridium botulinum in hams, bacon, the lactic acid bacilli domination is even more pronounced. The type of spoilage bacteria that will dominate is influenced by several factors that include raw or cooked meat product. Cooked products have a higher pH, greater than 6, which may allow growth of gram-facultative anaerobic pathogens like Yersinia enterocolitica. Raw products have a pH of about 5.6, which favors lactic acid bacteria, especially Lactobacillus, Carnobacterium and Leuconostoc. Nitrite concentration in meat. High nitrite concentration favors lactic acid bacteria. Low nitrite levels may allow growth of Brachothrix thermospacta, which is a gram-positive rod, growth at 0 to 30 degrees Celsius from pH 5 to 9. Bacillus thermospacta is an important spoilage bacterium in an aerobically stored meats kept at low temperature, but the bacterium is inhibited by nitrite. Slimy spoilage. Like other meat products, this occurs on the surface and is caused by the buildup of cells of yeast, lactobacilli, enterococci or Brachothrix thermospacta. Washing the slime off with hot water can restore the product quality. Sour spoilage. Results from growth of lactic acid bacteria, which originate from contaminated ingredients like milk solids under the casing. These organisms ferment lactose and other carbohydrates or other sugars in the product and produce organic acids. Taste is adversely affected, but the product is not harmful if eaten. Greening due to hydrogen peroxide or hydrogen sulfide production. Because greening indicates more extensive product breakdown, it would not be recommended eating green wieners. Spoilage of milk. In milk, the microorganisms that are principally involved in spoilage are psychrotropic organisms. Most psychrotropes are destroyed by pasteurization temperatures. However, some like Pseudomonas fluorescens, Pseudomonas franchi, can produce proteolytic and lipolytic extracellular enzymes which are heat stable and capable of causing spoilage. Some species and strains of Bacillus, Clostridium, Cornibacterium, Arthrobacter, Lactobacillus, Mycobacterium, Micrococcus and Streptococcus can survive pasteurization and grow at refrigeration temperatures, which can cause spoilage problems. Vegetables. Composition: 88% water, 8.6% sugars. pH of most veggies is around 6, within the growth range of many bacteria. Microflora of vegetables is primarily composed of gram-positive bacteria like lactic acid bacteria, example Leuconostocks, Lactobacilli, Streptococci, coriniforms and Staphylococci, the latter coming from the hands of employees during processing. Staphylococci are usually unable to proliferate, but cross-contamination can introduce them into other foods where growth conditions are more favorable. Soft rot. One of the most common types of bacterial spoilage caused by Erwinia carotovora and sometimes by Pseudomonas species, which grow at 4 degrees Celsius. Sources of contamination. Surface contamination by soil, water, air, human pathogens from manure, that is night soil. Harvesting, that is while hand picking versus machines. High damage if crop is ripe, harvest before ripe. Geotrichum candidum, mold on harvest or storage. Packaging, containers reused or sanitized. Processing plant, markets while handling cross contamination. The microflora of vegetables will generally reflect on the sanitation of processing steps as well as the condition of the original raw product. Soil-borne microorganisms such as Clostridia are common on raw vegetables, and some species like Clostridium botulinum are of such great concern that they are the focus of processing steps designed to destroy microorganisms. Fruits. Average composition: 85% water, 13% sugars, low pH at around 1.8 to 5.6. Specific spoilage organisms: blue rot, caused by Penicillium, fruits, downy mildews, Phytophthora, large masses of mycelium in grapes, black rot, Aspergillus in onions, sour rot, Geotrichum candidum. Dairy products. Milk is a very rich medium for spoilage organisms. Raw milk flora may include all microorganisms found on the cow hide, which includes soil and fecal bacteria, udder and milking utensils, can include gram-negative, gram-positive yeast and molds. When properly handled and stored, the flora of pasteurized milk is primarily gram-positive bacteria. Psychrotropic pseudomonads are common in bulk stored raw milk. Psychrotropic bacillus species are also common in raw milk. Pasteurized fluid milk, spoiled by a variety of bacteria, yeasts and molds. Milk was usually soured by lactic acid bacteria such as Enterococci, Lactococci or Lactobacilli, which drop the pH to 4.5, where the milk proteins coagulate, that is causes curdling. Milk is more frequently spoiled by aerobic spore formers such as bacillus, whose proteolytic enzymes cause curdling. Molds may grow on the surface of spoiled milk, but the product is usually discarded before this occurs. Butter, high lipid content and low water activity make it more susceptible to surface mold growth than to bacterial spoilage. Some pseudomonads can be a problem. Surface taint, putrid smell caused by the production of organic acids, especially isovaleric acid, from Pseudomonas putrefaciens, rancidity due to butterfat lipolysis caused by Pseudomonas franchi are common. Cottage cheese can be spoiled by yeast, molds and bacteria. The most common bacterial spoilage is slimy curd caused by Alkaligen species, which is a gram-negative aerobic rod bound in soil, water and intestinal tract of vertebrates. Like Campylobacter, these species do not oxidize sugars but instead use amino acids and citric acid cycle intermediates. Penicillium, mucor and other fungi also grow well on cottage cheese and impart stale or yeasty flavors. Ripened cheeses, low water activity, low pH, and high salt inhibit most spoilage organisms except surface mold growth. Spores of Clostridium butyricum, Clostridium sporogenes, and others can germinate in cheeses, for example, Swiss cheese, with intrinsic properties that are less inhibitory, example, lower salt, higher pH. These organisms may metabolize citrate, lactose, pyruvate, or lactic acid and produce butyrate or acetate plus carbon dioxide or hydrogen gas, which blows the cheese. Eggs. Eggs have several intrinsic parameters which help to protect the nutrient-rich yolk from microbial attack. These include the shell and associated membranes, as well as lysozyme, conalbumin, and a high pH, which is greater than 9, in the white. Freshly laid eggs are generally sterile, but soon become contaminated with numerous genera of bacteria. Eventually, these microorganisms will penetrate the eggshell and spoilage will occur. Pseudomonads are common spoilage agents, but molds like Penicillium and Cladosporium sometimes grow in the air sac and spoil the egg. Cereal and bakery foods. These products are characterized by a low water activity, which when stored properly under low humidity, restricts all microorganisms except molds. Rhizopus stolonifer is the common bread mold, and other species from this genus spoil cereals and other baked goods. Refrigerated frozen Dow products have more water and can be spoiled by lactic acid bacteria. Fermented foods and beverages. The low pH or ethanol content of these products does not allow growth of pathogens, but spoilage can occur. Beer and wine, pH 4 to 5, can be spoiled by yeast and bacteria. Bacteria involved are primarily lactic acid bacteria like lactobacilli and pediococcus species, and under aerobic conditions, acetic acid bacteria like acetobacter and gluconobacter species. Acetic acid bacteria convert ethanol to acetic acid in the presence of oxygen. Spoilage in packaged beer is often due to growth of the yeast Saccharomyces diastaticus, Saccharomyces diastaticus, which grows on dextrins that brewer's yeast cannot utilize. Candida valida is the most important spoilage yeast in wine. In either case, spoilage by yeast results in the development of turbidity, off flavors, and odors. Wines can also be spoiled by lactic acid bacteria, which are able to convert malic acid to lactic acid, which is the malolactic fermentation. Yeast, molds, and lactic acid bacteria can also spoil fermented vegetables such as sauerkraut and pickles, as well as other acid foods like salad dressings and mayonnaise. Spoilage in fermented vegetables is often manifest by off odors or changes in the color or texture, softening of the product. Common foodborne bacteria: gram-positive genera, bacillus, aerobic spore-forming rods, meso, cycro, and thermophilic species exist. This genus includes important spoilage species as well as pathogenic species which cause anthrax, that is Bacillus anthracis and Bacillus cereus, which can cause foodborne gastroenteritis. Due to the resistance of endospores to drying and most other stresses, aerobic spore formers are widely distributed in nature, but it is generally accepted that the primary habitat of most Bacillus species is soil, from which they contaminate everything by distribution in dust. Clostridium, anaerobic spore-forming rods. Like Bacillus, meso, cycro, and thermophilic species exist. The most notorious species are Clostridium botulinum, which causes botulism, and Clostridium perfringens, a common cause of gastroenteritis. Clostridia are ubiquitous. They are found in soil, sewage, decaying vegetation, animal and plant products, and in the intestinal tract of man and animals. Lactobacillus, very diverse genus of fastidious acid tolerant. Some can grow at pH lesser than 3, microaerophilic, non-spore forming rods. Lactobacilli are found in low numbers on all plant surfaces and are also an important part of the natural intestinal microbiota. Lactobacilli are included among the lactic acid bacteria, and this genera includes species used to ferment dairy, vegetable and meat products, as well as other species that are responsible for spoilage of acid foods and meats. Listeria, non-sporing rods, aerobic or facultatively aerobic. Mesophilic, but some species and strains can grow at temperatures as low as 1 degree Celsius or as high as 45 degrees Celsius. Listeria species are widely distributed in nature and can be isolated from water, mud, vegetation and from human and animal waste. This genus includes the important pathogen Leuconostoc monocytogenes. This genus includes the important pathogen Listeria monocytogenes that causes listeriosis in humans. Staphylococcus, mesophilic, facultatively anaerobic cocci. Staphylococci are primarily associated with skin glands and mucous membranes of warm-blooded animals. Staphylococcus aureus and some other species produces a heat-stable enterotoxin. Some toxins survive 16 hours at 60 degrees Celsius, that is a major cause of food poisoning, usually as a result of poor sanitation or hygiene. Gram-negative bacteria, Campylobacter, microaerophilic to anaerobic spirally curved rods, found in the intestinal and reproductive tracts of man and animals. This genus contains several pathogenic species such as Campylobacter jejuni. Escherichia, most thoroughly studied genus of bacteria, facultative anaerobic rods that are found in the lower intestine of warm-blooded animals. Because Escherichia coli are associated with fecal contamination, this species is used as an indicator of food safety and sanitation. Some strains of Escherichia coli cause food poisoning and are the leading cause of traveler's diarrhea. Pseudomonas. Without question, the single most important food spoilage group of bacteria. Aerobic rods, meso and psychrophilic species found in soils and water. Most of it cannot grow at pH lesser than 4.5. Few nutritional requirements. Some can even use hydrogen or carbon monoxide as energy sources. Several species produce pigmented compounds that fluoresce. Salmonella, mesophilic, facultatively anaerobic rods. All members of this genus are considered pathogenic, causing fever, gastroenteritis and septicemia. Salmonella have not been separated into different species, but instead are grouped into subgenera which contain related serovars defined by antigenic properties. Salmonella are intestinal organisms transmitted to humans by fecal contamination of food and water. Shigella. Like Salmonella, members of this genus are mesophilic, facultatively anaerobic rods and all are considered pathogenic. These bacteria are intracellular parasites of the epithelium of humans and higher primates. Vibrio, facultatively anaerobic, mesophilic, although some can grow at 4 degrees Celsius. They are rods found in fresh and salt water. Vibrio cholerae is the causative agent for epidemic cholera, and several other species are serious pathogens. Consumption of raw shellfish and fish are often linked to Vibrio outbreaks. Coming to the conclusion, spoilage caused by microorganisms like fungi, molds, yeast and bacteria. They are mesophiles, psychrotrophs and thermophiles. They spoil food by growing in it and producing substances that change the color, texture and odor of the food. Eventually, the food will be unfit for human consumption. Food spoilage directly affects the color, taste, odor and consistency or texture of food, and it may become dangerous to eat. Spoilage bacteria can cause fruits and vegetables to get mushy or slimy, or meat to develop a bad odor. Anaerobic or facultatively anaerobic spore formers are most likely to grow in canned foods. Fungi grow readily in acidic, low moisture environments. Thank you.